Sunday afternoon, Emily and I are going to, I don't know what it's called today. It's called vintage Japanese car meet or something. And we wanted to take a little bit of a break from working on the Rolla in the garage. So we showed up here at Love 20B to see some old school Toyotas and maybe any other old car.
Yeah.
And give you guys a tour. And then after this, we'll head back to the garage and finish the engine. Hooray!
Thank you.
We are back in the garage working on the TE-72. Emily's dealing with the dogs. You can see them behind her.
Yeah. Mad zoomies.
And we are going to be pulling the valve springs and the valves out of the 4AG head. And the cool thing is I already got two out, but I made this special tool on how to remove the valve retainer clips and the valve retainers. I stole this from another YouTube video, so I'm not that original, but man, it works great. You can see we got the springs out with the retainer, and then those are the two intake valves. So let me show you how it works. I'm gonna pop this on my little head and show you how it goes. But basically, this goes, the magnet goes down through a 19 millimeter socket. The vice grips go over that, and then you push down in unison. And what happens is it releases the bucket to the point where the clips are loose, and then the clips get sucked in by the magnet, and then everything comes loose. So let's see if we can do it. Do it again. What am I doing?
He's gonna make a makeshift thing.
To make a thing?
To make this thing come off. The spring attached to the piston.
Valve retainer clip.
The retainer clip.
But this is not riveting content, so we'll start with recording when I get
it. Fine.
Look at that. I already came through. And then the trick is to line it up in the middle. When you push, and you should be able to just... Okay, look,
it
I got
worked.
One.
Oh, nice.
See how I got one? Boom. And we're going to put this here so it doesn't fall. Now we're going to try and get the other side. It might actually just go now. Again, the trick is to line it in the middle. Push. Got it.
Woo!
Look at how easy that was.
Damn.
And then these go in our nice little organization bucket. Thank you, sweetheart.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Oh. Oh, well, whatever.
Oh, that was the second one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, this one was bent.
Oh, shit.
It's a bent valve. 100%. So watch, it won't come through the valve guide.
Uh-huh.
Because it's bent. If it was straight,
oh,
it would just pop through. But
okay.
See how it's stuck at the bottom here? Looks like we might need... new valves and new valve guides. Oh no.
Damn it.
Seem a little bent.
Oh, I see it.
To the, mm-hmm. It looks like it's a little wavy.
Mm-hmm. Little bit.
Look at all the just junk around where the valve seats.
Mm-hmm.
So that could be just a bad seat there. But once we get to the exhaust valves, it should be easier because they're bigger, but this one does not look so good.
12 more to go. Can you hear a click?
It's hard, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll get back on it.
Yeah. I don't have as much leverage. I got one. That was so satisfying. Sorry. Okay.
One sec. Good boy, Kodak.
Oh, that felt like it did it. Oh, I got one! Jesus.
Emily and I just worked our butt off, and the head is ready to go to a machine shop. Here it is on the ground. We put it on the ground so we can get more leverage. We pulled out all the valve seals, and boy, oh boy, are those in horrible condition. Really bad condition, and the block's almost ready to go to the machine shop. We have to pull this, so I gotta buy the right socket for the oil sandwich plate, pull the crank out, there's a couple more bolts in there, and then that should be able to go to the machine shop. And then while we were doing that, we were trying to install the correct Japanese bumper brackets, the correct Japanese bumper and the correct Japanese bumper end caps to the TE-72. But here's something I didn't know. The USDM TE-72s have the fenders that allow for such a big corner, and they actually kind of, you can call them like smiley bumpers. The bumper caps go up here, and then there's a bolt that holds them in place. Every other generation of TE-72 or KE-70 does not have this bumper system. They have a bumper where the bumper cap goes down and this hole isn't here. And so we bought the JDM bumpers for every other KE-70 where the bumper cap goes down. See how it doesn't match this line? It actually sits in a little bit more. So we bought the wrong bumper, but that's okay because we're gonna do the four headlight conversion. And that just basically means Emily and I, hi Emily, need to spend more money to change the front end to the four headlight conversion. It'll come with the front valance, the correct fenders, and then we can throw on, hi Onyx, the correct Japanese bumper with our four headlights. So it's funny because every time we go to work on the car and do something, we uncover more things that need to be changed. It's the same with the engine. You know, we bought the FX16 to pop the engine out and put it in, but as soon as we did a leak down test, we found out cylinder 3 was toast, so we can't run that. Now we have to rebuild the engine. There's a lot here. The sun is still up, but the dogs need a WALK. I can't say it, otherwise they're going to jump on me. And I need to edit all this stuff and make like 5 episodes tonight. So we got a lot to do. If you like it, drop us a comment. Let us know that you like the vlog. If you don't like the vlog, that's fine. We're just doing this because we want to document this build. That's cool with us. Let us know where you want to take it or where you want us to go with the build. And we'll see you on the flip side.